Good morning children, welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Today we are going to discuss the assignment on the topic dryness from class 9. Let us see the first question is, name the river that flows parallel to Himalayas. First question is, name the river that flows parallel to Himalayas. Answer is River Brahmaputra. River Brahmaputra. So here the river which is a flow parallel to the Himalayas, as we know that Himalayas are run from the Jammu Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh, north to Himalayas, we can see in the Tibetan region, this Brahmaputra, at first it originated as a glacier and then it opened into the navigable channel like river and it flowed. Okay, so the river which is flow parallel to the Himalayas is the answer is River Brahmaputra. Let us see the second question is, where do the River Brahmaputra takes U-turn? Where do the River Brahmaputra takes U-turn? Answer is at mountain Namcha Barwa. Namcha Barwa. It is one of the highest mountain peak in Himalayas. So after Namcha Barwa, River Brahmaputra takes a U-turn and then enter into India. Let us see the third question. In which state River Brahmaputra enters into our country? Third question is, in which state River Brahmaputra enters into our country? Answer is at Arunachal Pradesh. In Arunachal Pradesh, we can see this River Brahmaputra enter into India. Okay, then let us see the fourth question is, by what name River Brahmaputra is known in Bangladesh? Third question is, by what name River Brahmaputra is known in Bangladesh? Answer is River Jamuna. Means once the Brahmaputra enter into the Bangladesh after flowing India, then it is known as River Jamuna. With the name of River Jamuna, it joins with River Padma. Let us see the next question. That is, River Brahmaputra is also known as River Brahmaputra is also known as dash in Tibet country. Answer is Sankur. So Brahmaputra is known with different names in different countries. As we know that Brahmaputra in Tibet country it is known as Sankur and in Bangladesh it is known as Jamuna. Okay, then let us see the next question. Before that, let me erase the questions. Okay, let us go with the sixth question. Why the river Sankur carries less volume of water and silt? Sixth question is why the river Sankur carries less volume of silt and water. Answer is, as the river is flowing from dry and cool region. Cool region means as most of the Sankur is flow in the Tibet region, that we can know that Tibetan region has high elevated area or high altitude, so temperatures are very low and that too dry region. That's why very less volume of silt and water it carries. Then let us see the next question. Seventh question is, name the rivers that flow in west direction. And make eastwards. So answer, river Narmada and river Tapi. So here we can say this, name the rivers that flow west direction and makes the easterlies. Means generally in India rivers can flow towards the north. From the central Indian rivers they flow towards the north and joins with river Ganga or Yamuna, and come to the Deccan Plateau most of the rivers they flow from the west to east direction. But there are two rivers like river Narmada and Tapi, they flow towards the west direction and they form the easterlies, and finally they joins with the river Arabian Sea. Okay, then let us see the eighth question is, name the major rivers of peninsula. Name the major rivers of peninsula. So the major rivers of peninsula are river Mahanadi, river Godavari, river Kaveri or river Krishna and river Kaveri. Okay, so these are the major rivers which they flow towards the in peninsula India. Let us see the next question. Eighth question is, which river is marked by which river is marked by huge deposits of silt. Huge deposits of silt. on its bed. On its bed, rising, causing the river bed to rise. Causing the river bed to rise. So answer is River Brahmaputra. River Brahmaputra. So on River Brahmaputra, which they deposit a huge amount of silt so that the river bed is siltation. Due to the process of siltation, the river bed rises into the height. So the river, which is called as River Brahmaputra. And then go with the 10th question is, name the tributaries that joins, name the tributaries that joins with River Brahmaputra or joins River Brahmaputra. Answer, River Dabang and River Lohit. River Lohit and the River Dabang, which two are the tributaries which they join with the River Brahmaputra. Okay, then come to the 11th question, that is map pointing. So map pointing, let us see here. They asked us five important rivers: River Ghagra, River Lohit, River Son, River Petwa and River Gomati. So River Ghagra, which they had its origin in the Nepal Himalayas, and they flow towards the south and joins with River Ganga. River Ganga. Okay. And then River Lohit. River Lohit, which is one of the tributary of River Brahmaputra. Just now we discussed it here, right? It is one of the tributary of River Brahmaputra, which flows in Arunachal Pradesh and joins with River Brahmaputra. And then River Son. River Son had its origin in Chhattisgarh and joins with River Ganga. Okay. And then River Betwa. River Betwa had its origin in Madhya Pradesh and it is one of the tributary of River Yamuna. So it is joins with River Yamuna. River Gomati. River Gomati had its origin in Uttar Pradesh and it flows towards the south and finally it joins with River Ganga. So River Ghagra, Lohit, Son, Betwa, Gomati. We can say all these are the river system of River Ganga. Okay, children. Thank you and have a nice day.